The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice, let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, and darkness tries to hide. And trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great.
Good morning and welcome to Rockwood First Congregational Church. I'm Pastor Dave Pineski, and we are delighted that you decided to join us for our worship services this morning. Before we begin with that, I do have a few announcements. Our first announcement is Happy Memorial Day. Tomorrow will be Memorial Day on Monday, and it'll be a time that hopefully we will be able to connect with our families and especially say thanks to all the veterans that are in our families and around the country, as well as those that have put their life on the line for our freedoms, and we want to make sure that we remember them. Secondly, our newsletter has been sent out. We're understanding that some of you may not have received it yet. We know that the Postal Service is moving rather slow right now, and what we have done is now we are emailing it out. So if you, if we don't have your email address and you'd like to get our newsletter by email in a PDF format, please call the church at 734 734 379-3711. And then the last thing on my list of announcements is our toiletry co-op is open. It's fully stocked and it's available to help those that are in need. So please have those that are in need call the church office so we can fulfill those needs and to lift people up in our community. And with that said, let's ready our hearts. Let's ready our minds. Be glad and rejoice. Be glad and rejoice. For in our joy, we bring glory to God. And with Christ's loving presence, let us worship our God this morning. Please join me in singing our opening hymn, Stand By Me. When the storms of life are raging, stand by me. When the storms of life are raging, stand by me. When the world is tossing me like a ship upon the sea, thou who rulest wind and water, stand by me. In the midst of tribulation, stand by me. In the midst of tribulation, stand by me. Join me in our invocation and Lord's Prayer. Holy God, we celebrate your presence this day. For the gift of resurrection, we give you thanks and praise. For the gift of your ongoing presence in our lives, we rejoice and sing. Overwhelm us with your presence here, that we might be overwhelmed with joy In joyous gratitude we pray. Amen. It was Jesus who taught us all how to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. My friends, let us ready our hearts, let us ready our minds, and let us pray. Almighty God, your Son Jesus said to his disciples, "Go back to Jerusalem and wait." Lord, we are not good at waiting for anything. And a lot of us have been waiting at home, hoping and praying for some relief from our at-home isolation. We want a plan to be laid out for us so that we can resume our lives once again. We have some real control issues to overcome, O Lord. Take our spirits and release the need of our control over certain matters. Help us place our trust in your abiding love and presence. Give us patience and persistence to do our ministries at home, to make calls, to encourage others, to lift them up, to pray with them in their time of need. Lord, we also pray for your Holy Spirit to guide us and to help us make the right decisions, to formulate the right plans for our church's future. As we discuss our new normalcy for our worship and our church life, O Lord, we bring to you the names of family members and friends and those whose lives are in need of your healing mercies and comfort. Remind us that we also stand in need of those same mercies. We ask for your Holy Spirit to be with all those who are viewing this service as we lift up to you all of our prayers in silence now. Almighty God, we love you, we thank you. Give us courage to accept your love and strength, to witness to your love in all that we do. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Oh, join me in our scripture reading today, 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 6 through 11. Humble yourself, therefore, under the mighty hand of God, so that he may exalt you in due time. Cast all your anxiety on him, because he cares for you. Discipline yourselves. Keep alert. Like a roaring lion, your adversary, the devil, prowls around, looking for someone to devour. Resist him, steadfast in your faith, for you know that your brothers and sisters in all the world are undergoing the same kinds of suffering. And after you have suffered for a little while, the God of all grace, who has called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself restore, support, strengthen, and establish you. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen. May God add his blessing to the reading of his word this morning. Have you ever heard of an organization called the Barna Group? They are a private research organization, and they conduct and analyze research data to understand cultural trends that may be occurring today. These are trends that are related to values, beliefs, attitudes, and behaviors. They did some research about this. What Americans think about the Bible. What Americans think about the Bible. It really sheds some light. It brings a lot of things to the surface. What Americans think, how they feel, about their thoughts, about their attitudes, their beliefs in the Bible. And I'd like to share some of these discoveries with you today. Did you know that two-thirds of Americans, that's 66%, have expressed some curiosity. Now think about that word for a minute. Have expressed some curiosity. They want to know more about what the Bible says. In fact, 63% of adults who were surveyed are interested in knowing more about Jesus the Christ. Think about that for a moment. We've had two generations of unchurched people, and there's a lot of adults that have no idea about Jesus. Did you know that half of Americans think a lot about how the Bible applies in their life? Just think about that for a moment. Where do you think they're going to find the answer to that question? Here's another discovery. People think that by reading the Bible, it can positively impact their spiritual growth. The answer is yes, it will. More than half of the Bible users that were surveyed said that reading the Bible, it has resulted in their willingness to engage more actively in their faith. Here's another fact. 54% said as a result of their engagement with the Bible, that they, listen to this, have become more loving to others. Whoa, that's a good one. 42% of them said that they were more generous with their time, and more generous with their financial resources. 57% said that they used the Bible, that when they're using the Bible, they have a greater awareness that they need God more, that they need God more, much more. Here's a few more discoveries. 6 in 10 Americans, that's 58%, believe that the message of the Bible, the message of the Bible has transformed their lives. Married adults who have children under 18 said this. They indicated that the Bible has been life-changing for their families. My friends, this isn't the Bible saying this. This is people who were surveyed that said this. These were Americans. And they are witnessing about God's truths. They're witnessing how the Holy Spirit is still working out in our community, and it's touching people's hearts about God's Word, about the Father, about the Son, and about the Holy Spirit. I think it's important we know that there are a lot of people that we connect with each day. Two-thirds of family members, friends and coworkers and others, people we know who are curious about the Bible. Two-thirds who are thinking about how the Bible applies to their life. You are their friend. They know you. You know them. Who want to be more loving in their life. Who want to be more giving in their life. Who want to give back. Who want to be transformed by the Lord's Holy Spirit. I came across another article called The Top 8 Things People Desperately Desire. The Top 8 Things People Desperately Desire But Can't Seem to Attain. The first on the list, number one, was happiness. And the big challenge there was not knowing what I want to do. Not knowing what I want to do. The number two on the list, and the big challenge there, is money. Not having enough money. Well, there's a lot of people that can relate to that. Or not having enough time to accomplish the things that I want to do. And number three on the list was freedom. And the big challenge there is not having the freedom to find my true purpose. Not having the freedom to find my true purpose. Number four is peace. And the big challenge there is lack of clarity. Lack of clarity about who I am. About my purpose, about who I am and about my purpose. Number five was joy. And the big challenge here is how to find the right role, find the right position that will bring joy to my work. Number six is balance, and a lot of people are looking for balance. And the big challenge here is balancing my desire of flexibility, so people like flexibility, while making enough money and having the benefits that they want. And number seven was fulfillment. And fulfillment, the big challenge here is utilizing my potential in the best way possible for myself and for others. And the last thing is, number eight, is confidence. And I see that a lot today. And the big challenge here is I feel I have something to offer now. But yet, I have a feeling as to that I'm not ready, or that I need more training. My friends, I find it interesting that there are a lot of people who cannot find happiness in both of these surveys. They cannot seem to find their purpose. They cannot seem to find their joy. They cannot find fulfillment in their lives. And there are so many people that have been so gifted by the Lord. My friends, the Lord wants everyone to prosper, to have a life full of abundance, which will help build people's confidence that they need to be successful. Verse 7 in today's scripture says, cast all your anxieties on him. Think about all these things that we have discussed so far, to throw those barriers on him because he cares for you, because he loves you. And it all starts with one thing, faith. Having faith in our Lord Jesus the Christ. Think about this. Of all those eight desires, all of them can easily be obtained with faith. Only if you have the right role model in your life. We have also learned today that 2 in 3 Americans are curious. They're curious about the Bible and what it says. They're curious about learning about Jesus the Christ. It's not surprising when you consider that we've had 2 generations of unchurched people. If you open up your Bibles to Psalm 55:22, it says, pile your troubles on God's shoulders. And the Lord has big, wide shoulders. He will carry your load. He will help you out. He will never let you, the good person that you are, collapse into ruin. But that will not happen to you if you don't take the next step towards satisfying your curiosity. The curiosity that is tugging on your heart, that's tugging on your mind, that's tugging on your soul. It is the Lord knocking on your door. If you never seek God, you will always get the same results that you have always gotten. If we are suffering heavy trials, we lose a friend, our health is diminishing. If we lose our stuff or our property, if we lose our willpower to move forward, we are in real danger of being crushed. Crushed by false promises that come from outside in the world. Those false promises may have led you to this very point. Regardless of what you may be going through, our Lord wants to carry all of your burdens. You may be lucky enough to find someone to listen to your problems. But in most cases, the world around us, outside these walls of the church, they're not interested in your problems and they're not interested in your burdens. Especially if we are cast down to our knees. We can lose everything in one single day. It just happened the other day in Milan. People lost everything in one day. And Jesus will turn to you when the world is turning away from you. Jesus will reach out his hand to you. And Jesus is happy and willing to listen to what you have to say. He wants to know what's on your mind. His Holy Spirit is with you and I. He's with us. And he says to you, give me all your heavy burdens, and I will carry them for you. The world may have forgotten who you are, but you were created beautifully by our Creator. You may be poor. You may be despised by others. And you may be crushed by the world. But remember this, that you will never be neglected by our God. In the last 2 months, we have all been directed to stay home, to stay safe. And we have all learned new ways to live our lives today. And it's been difficult. And I'm sure it has humbled every one of us in many ways. And has made us more thankful for the things that we did have, the freedoms that we had. We are constantly reminded every single day by many news reports that provide us with lots of thoughts, lots of ideas, and lots of stories. With so many different stories about affliction, of anxiety, and the many different types of suffering that people around the world are experiencing. Our scripture reminds us that we need to be steadfast in our faith. We also need to know that we have brothers and sisters in Christ all around the world who are going through the same kind of sufferings that we are as a result of this pandemic. We are not alone. Our scripture also reminds us to be humble, to humble ourselves, not to exalt ourselves above others, but rather to focus on God the Father, God the Son, and the Holy Spirit. To love God with all our hearts. To love God with all our mind. With all our soul. With all our strength. To love our neighbors as Jesus has loved us. The Bible, from cover to cover, speaks about loving and loving our neighbors. It's a matter of time when the Lord will raise us up from our current state of sadness, or it could be boredom or loneliness, which is a form of suffering. If we are looking for happiness in our lives, and there are a lot of people who are looking for happiness in their lives, it all begins with humility. And many people's challenges today, as we heard, is not knowing what they want to do, not knowing what they want to do. It's about humbling those desires and putting others before yourself. This will help you. This will help you find your purpose. The Lord's Holy Spirit will guide you to help you find your purpose. This will bring God glory, and God will exalt you in due time. Now, Peter is reminding all Christians who may be experiencing some type of persecution or some type of suffering, those who have been exposed to, let's say, the virus, to loneliness, to the loss of a loved one. The fact is that we are not alone in our suffering. We can bear the pain more easily when we are not alone, because we have our Christian family to lean on, to help us. Our scripture warns us about the adversary. He is like a roaring lion. I've been speaking about this devil for the last 2 weeks. He likes to prowl around looking for someone to devour. This is the time he likes to attack. We are to resist him. We are to put on the full armor of God every single day. The suffering that you may be experiencing will not last forever. It will not be long. It will not be long before our generous God, who has great plans for you and I, and a great purpose for you and I in Christ Jesus. My friends, these are eternal plans, glorious plans. And our Lord Jesus the Christ will restore us. He will support us. He will strengthen us as he puts us back on our feet. All we need to do is lift up our burdens to him. May the Lord's Holy Spirit touch your mind and bring you new meaning to his word this day, so that you can apply these things in your lives. To him be the power forever and ever. Amen. Please join me in singing our closing hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul."
Sorrow.
Has risen from death itself. Joy to the world. Christ's glory is ours to share. May the Lord watch over you and your families. Amen.